The countdown is on for the Tokyo Olympics. The Games are scheduled for July 23rd to August 8th, and the Paralympics from August 24th to September the 5th. The one-year delay has already brought with it plenty of complications, and there are still some unanswered questions regarding things like spectator numbers and the so-called playbooks. Some 11,000 Olympic athletes will compete in 33 sports, while over 4,000 Paralympians will compete across 22 sports. But with Japan's elderly population only just starting to receive inoculations, there will be a need for restrictions still. International spectators will not be allowed.
アスリートとしてオリンピックを何度か経験をさせていただきました。自国から開催地に来ることができないということは本当に残念です。
Organizers plan to decide in April on the maximum number of local fans permitted in venues. Japanese sports arenas have been recently operating at up to 50% capacity. Are athletes required to be vaccinated? The simple answer is no. But the International Olympic Committee urges them to be vaccinated once vaccinations are made available to the general population of their countries. Participants must follow the health guidelines in their playbook. What is it? First unveiled in February, the playbooks outline the rules that all games participants must follow. That includes mandatory mask wearing, keeping 2 meters distance from other athletes, and clapping instead of singing or shouting to show support. Athletes will also be tested at least once every 4 days.
And I had no hesitation in saying that the games will take place and they'll be the safest games possible.
Japan is holding several test events, seen as dress rehearsals, to confirm the Games' operational capabilities at venues and test out health protocols. Early May, we'll see 4 such events with athletes coming from abroad. There will be no shortage of compelling action once the Games kick off. 4 sports will debut at this year's Olympics: karate, sport climbing, surfing and skateboarding. Several stars, from French judoka Teddy Riner to American swimmer Katie Ledecky, will be back in the quest for more gold. Japanese swimmer Rikako Ike, competing after her recovery from leukemia, will no doubt be among the most emotional moments of the Games.